Is this working? What's going on, guys? Thank you so much for clicking on the video. The Skate Informant here. Let's get straight to it. What is the future looking like for the traditional skate shop? I'm talking about the mom and pop shop, core skater owned skate shop, brick and mortar skate shop. The reason why I ask is personally, in my personal experience, in the DFW where I live, North Texas, it is a trend that I see no matter where I look, where every skate shop that exists around me, that is a core skate shop, has gone through a massive financial crisis. I've had a skate shop in my area called Index Skate Shop. Shout out Index, rest in peace, but shout out Index, under that name at least. And it basically shut down, went bankrupt. Now they resurfaced under another name to perhaps, my only prediction is to not necessarily avoid, but to find like a little loophole or just kind of continue to exist without bringing over the burden of the previous name and perhaps any debt or legalities they were involved in. So now it's changed its name after, I don't know, plus 10 years, but that happened to them. I had another skate shop that was very close to me physically in my area called the General Store. It existed for a few years. Now it's gone, completely bankrupt. There's been other skate shops that no longer exist because they just went under. And I've had the opportunity to interview former skate shop owners. And they tell me, kind of just like blew my mind. I'll maybe link the video down below, but shout out Paris. He owned a skate shop in, I guess, the Lake Worth area, Sampson Park area. Again, very particular to my area, but he owned a shop there, and he told me in this interview that you cannot operate a skate shop with the income or the revenue of that shop alone. He said you needed to have an outside source. I mean, coming from a person... I mean, yeah, that's blew my mind because coming from a person that, you know, all my life I've worked in the, you know, corporate heavy back-end business, you know, world. I've managed several departments in big corporations. Anyways, that to me is a setup for failure. How can a business call itself a business if it's at a loss every month or every quarter, every period, whatever it is that you decide to measure your success? How can you continue to exist if you continue to lose money? That is a recipe for disaster. Basically, you can't sustain yourself. Your costs exceed your income. Like the cost of your building, your brands that you carry, any other costs associated to Wi-Fi, power, anything that you need to exist is not off balance with the amount of money you sell, you know, product you sell, money you make. So if that is to be true, if you need an outside source, then by default, the infrastructure of your average skate shop is broken. Now, this is beyond North Texas because, for example, I have this article here. Somebody else asked here on Reddit, like, hey, why are these skate shops dying? Granted, this is 3 years ago, but my point still prevails. Everywhere I look, I see skate shop shutting down. Any tips to avoid this? And I agree with the vast majority of the comments here. You know, well-made websites, online stores, good customer service, more board sizes. I would like to focus on the first three because, you know, this is marketing and strategizing. And this is more, you know, once you've already... you know, apprehended people's attention, then you have something to offer, but you can have all the sizes in the world here, boards, and you still, people may not even know you exist. Some people state that, you know, there's a resurgence, more shops are surfacing, but that doesn't speak to the longevity, like how long will the shops be in existence? There's another comment, somebody went into like great detail saying how, people, skate shop owners, don't seem to invest heavily. They may have some level of online presence, but they don't dive into heavy online sales. Quick example, not a diss, just calling out facts. homies at Shredder's Skate Shop, which is basically in Wise County / Decatur, the only shop in that area. He does sell online, and he actually sells international, but the amount of time that it takes, it's like a one-person operation, or even two people at the most, is that, you know, he's juggling several businesses. He works at a family restaurant, then he has a shop that therefore it speaks on the outside source of income. And then I told him going into the pandemic, I say, hey man, I support you 100%. Let's get that website up and running, you know, get all the products listed. I'll give shout outs on the channel, on the Instagram account. But because he's just so busy, he can't, you know, cut out the time to fully, you know, present that shop to the world where it's conducive, where it makes sense, where it's easy to navigate, custom, you know, friendly, user-friendly. So many obstacles that you can run into. Definitely not his fault, but if the shop owners don't do it, who will? So that's something else that's hindering the growth. To this conversation earlier this year, I came across this article from ABC News, ABC 7. Let's just check it out. It talks about Active Ride Shop. Active, you know, gigantic shop. I have more respect to these guys than I do up to Zoomies, of course. But here's what's happening to them, or here's what happened to something at their, earlier this year.
Breaking news travels fast.
Come on. Get through the commercial.
With real-time speed
we get it. We get it. You have cars you can drive. Play a camera. News. Here we go.
Southern California's number one skate shop may be shutting its doors for good soon. Active Ride Shop's lender plans to conduct a foreclosure auction to get rid of all the assets related to the company, including intellectual property, inventory, and other things. Active's website has currently shut down all e-commerce and has a message that says it's down for construction. Well, several of its stores have reported they plan to close in the coming days.
Okay, so that is Active. Again, gigantic in the skate presence. They've sponsored athletes like P-Rod at one point. Just big names, right? Like they said, biggest name, number one shop in SoCal. The site is up now. They have very little product in here, and they don't carry hardly any other brands outside of, you know, their main ones and their own. Who knows what happened with the legalities? I'm not involved in those conversations, but even if you have a gigantic presence in skateboarding like they did, you're still undergoing possibilities of shutting down. I'm telling you, the infrastructure of skate shops is broken. I'll say it again. Skate shops, the way they're designed, the target audience, the sales, the revenue, the cost of operating, that is currently broken. And when highly intelligent, highly agile, and of course with deep pockets, you know, analysts and experts come into the court to play this game, they're going to outplay every core skater that wants to own a shop. Therefore, that's why Zoomies has been strong for like freaking, I don't know, man, going like 15 years now. You have to be very, very conscious of your surroundings, the environment, you know, the times that you're living in, and how you plan on staying in existence for long periods of time. You have to think about the future. Not saying everyone is like this. Of course, I'm not like this, but I would say that the majority of skaters that I come across, and skaters that are like good and cool and have passion for it, they don't, you know, I hope I'm wrong, right? And no disrespect whatsoever, but they don't really, you know, come off as the dude that worries about the future, about tomorrow, planning ahead, financial, you know, guru type of person. I just want to shred, you know, and I want to do my thing, you know, and that's it. And then you want to become a business owner, and you see the consequences of that lack of awareness. Again, awesome dudes. Every person that I've ever met that owns a shop, that runs a shop, that is operator shop, dope dudes. Sickest dudes, chillest dudes, absolutely. But that doesn't guarantee you're going to be an expert in the business world. So if Active's, you know, falling off the grid here, charts in a negative way, that's pretty scary to say the least. Also, there's an article from Yahoo Finance talking about just markets and retailers in general. And just listen to this and let it hit and just meditate on this. More retailers went bankrupt in 2020 than during the Great Recession. Let's think about that for a second. More businesses closed, died, stopped existing this year, that still hasn't ended, by the way, than in the Great Recession. Let that hit. Now, of course, because we're living in the moment, we're living in the year, it's easier to miss, right? Like, wait, I mean, things are fine, right? I mean, yeah, I guess, you know, skate shop down the street is still open, so it must be good. Like, bro, behind the scenes, stuff is hurting bad, all right? And just because you made it through 2020 does not guarantee that you're in the clear. 2021 is about to hit. And I guess their predictions towards 2020 is this. Like, for example, we had an overwhelming amount of money injected into the economy in 2020 because it was the first time this happened. Government has never seen something like this in the past 100 years. And we wanted to stay alive and keep businesses alive as much as we possibly could. So a lot of money was injected into the economy that wasn't really there. It was given to us, given to retailers to keep employees, things running, you know, wheels turning. But that sustainability is artificial, right? That wasn't actual money that came naturally, organically into the economy. It was stuff that was artificially padded. Will we get the same stuff in 2021? There's talks about getting money, more money. People are not happy, etc. But at one point, they're going to rip off that Band-Aid and it's going to expose what's really happening. Can businesses really pay their mortgages, their rent, their bills, their employees? Can they still get those products? Do they sign contracts with these shoe dealers, you know, to get more shoes in? And I've heard this by several skate shop owners, the shoe game in skateboarding, you know, skate shops is super dangerous, especially as you're messing around with these corporate brands like Nike's and all the big ones. That is a slippery slope to play. You may end up under really quickly. So just things to note, of course, commercial real estate is expected to drop 2021 just so they can meet the, you know, customer. And, you know, in the middle, like, okay, look, we'll lower the price, don't end the contract, because even though the owner's going to default and the owner's going to go bankrupt, you know, of the skate shop or of this business owner of this or that, at the end of the day, the owner of the real estate still wants to have a tenant, because if you have a tenant, you're getting passive income, you're getting income. If you don't have a tenant, you're not making money and you're eating the cost. So it's in everyone's benefit that these properties stay busy, stay occupied. So they're going to lower the real estate cost in 2021, but until the vaccine hits, their predictions for 2021 and even 2022 and beyond that is going to skyrocket past the other previous years, like past even from 2008. It's going to exceed that. It's in a peak. So yeah, that's just crazy. So if are we going to be that empty in the future? Will it be that empty? Like, if this is true, if 20% increase of vacant offices will exist, who do you think is going to take the first hit? The giant corporate brands or the small pop shops, the skater owned? Who will be the first ones to go? Who has less residue income to support them through difficult times? It's going to be the skate shops. I would hate to see more skate shops, you know, leave the scene, you know, given the circumstances that people have already observed in the past years. It's already happening. It's been happening. And 20% more will disappear. That is gnarly. That is crazy. So again, I propose the following question. What is the future of the skater-owned skate shops out there? Is this really the beginning of the end? Is this really the first step towards complete extinction? Will the future of skate shops be 100% online sales? Now, here's an interesting topic, very interesting topic. Some skaters, and I include myself in there, have called in the past, you know, called out, I guess, mall corporate industries because of their size and how they're hijacking, you know, the skate customer base, audience per se, because of their size, kind of jumped the gun. Yeah, they're fake. They're corporate. Don't shop there. Shop, you know, small businesses. But small is just a side effect. Small could be a side effect of poor operations, poor business strategy, and just poor managing of money, of resources. Small isn't a goal that someone should have as a business owner. Because I guaranteed you, 80% of business owners, if they had a chance to grow, keep their core beliefs, but grow, they're going to do it. Growth just means more money, more opportunity, a bigger outreach to customers. So when you say support small businesses, I believe that mentality is slightly flawed. But let's just say they're still small, etc. Can a core shop still be 100% online? Just because you won't walk into the shop and talk to the skate shop owner, you know, shake his hand, walk around the shop, chill with them for a little bit. It doesn't mean that they're not core. Having an online presence may be the only way the future of skate shops will be. This guy has so many topics, so many thoughts, so many possibilities. I'm super interested in hearing you out, what you think about the future, because we're going to be there no matter what. No, whether you agree, whether you disagree, whether you totally agree with me, whether you hate, you know, these predictions, we're going to be there. We're headed in that direction now. These are financial predictions from Yahoo Finance and other sources that has nothing to do with skate shops. It's just a business in general. And they are predicting 20% of these mortar physical buildings that exist will be gone. Do you honestly think that's not going to be some skate shops? Guys, that is the end of this video. Just my thoughts on the future 2021 and you know, skater-owned skate shops. Let me know what you think. Or if you are a skate shop owner, let's do this. If you're a skate shop owner, DM me, I don't know, at the Skate Informant, or just comment here on the video. I would like to sit down with you, maybe podcast style interview, maybe a Zoom interview, and we'll air it later. Yeah, I really want to get to the down, you know, details, nitty gritty of what it means to own a skate shop. I already talked to a few people. I want to keep that conversation going. So guys, thanks so much for watching the video. Once again, I am the Skate Informant. You've been informed. My job here is done. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.